with a combination of phasing out poppy crop eradication, upgrading agriculture, and upgrading interdiction, which has had spectacular results. The military is taking down drug dealers, paraphernalia, drug bazaars, setting off vast bonfires of opium in the desert. This is the most successful thing we've done so far, and we have increasing evidence that it's really disrupting the Taliban internally, their financial efforts. Rami Shah will talk about that in a moment. And we're very pleased at the direction that's going. Holding an election in a wartime situation is always difficult. Holding one when the enemy has said they're going to try to disrupt it makes it even more difficult. And holding it under historic conditions, which Rena, Barney, and Jane already alluded to, and they could go on forever about how this relates to the tribes and the ethnic groups and the history of the country, is even more daunting. But a government needs legitimacy. And this election was called for under the Constitution for April 21st, 2009. When President Obama took the oath of office on January 20th, it was apparent that this could not be done on schedule because of decisions made last year, decisions which I, for one, publicly criticized as a private citizen. The decision to ignore the Constitution and delay the election has caused a reorientation of our priorities for the first 6.5 months of this administration. We know the difference between input and output. And what you're seeing here is input, agriculture, rule of law, counter-narcotics, the illicit financing. That's what we're doing. The payoff is still to come. We have to produce results, and we understand that. And we're not here today to tell you we're winning or we're losing. We're not here today to say we're optimistic or pessimistic. We're here to tell you that we're in this fight in a different way, with a determination to succeed under the direct personal supervision of the President, Secretary of State, and the rest of the Cabinet. In Secretary Clinton's speech, and I would draw your attention to this, she laid out the fact that that we would support the reintegration into Afghan society of any people fighting with the Taliban who renounce al-Qaeda and lay down their weapons and reintegrate peacefully. But on your key point, a question we're always asked, I think it needs to be stated very clearly that if you abandon the struggle in Afghanistan, you will suffer against al-Qaeda as well. But we have to be clear on what our national interests are here. After this process has determined a winner, and there'll be disputes as they are in American elections. We only picked a senator from Minnesota just a few weeks ago after a rather lengthy delay. And so after this is settled, we will be looking to the government, and when I say we, I want to echo what Jane Marriott said. We means the international community. This has been one of the main topics that I've discussed with my 24, 25 counterparts. We will be asking the government to reinvigorate, or invigorate if it's a different president, the leadership in these fields that you've heard today.